Welcome to my dear second year students. Now we are going to discuss about electrostatic charges and fields class 2. Now already we are discussing about the properties of charges. What is the charges quantized? The most important topic. Charges quantized. It is properties of charges. Charges quantized. What is the meaning of charges quantized? The total charge of body is equal to integer multiple of electron charge. But total body charges means Q. Integer and electron charge E here plus or minus. From this equation Q means total body charge. N is equal to integer multiple. The value is equal to 1, 2, 3, so on. And E means electron charge. The value is equal to E equal to 1.602 into the power of minus 19 coulombs. Okay. Now from this formula, now we have solved some problems. Problem number 2. How many electrons in constitute in 1 millicoulomb charge? 1 millicoulomb charge. Once again, how many electrons constitute in 1 millicoulomb charge? From this problem, on given some term, the charge Q is equal to 1 millicoulomb. But milli is equal to how much? It is a small unit of the charge. 1 milli means 10 to the power of minus 3. Similarly, 1 micro means 10 to the power of minus 6. And 1 nano means 10 to the power of minus 9. And 1 pico, 10 to the power of minus 2. These are small units of the charge in milli, micro, nano, pico. Milli means 10 to the power of minus 3. And micro value 10 to the power of minus 6. Nano value 10 to the power of minus 9. Pico is equal to 10 to the power of minus 2. So from this problem, then 1 millicoulomb. Milli is equal to how much? Then Q is equal to 1 into milli means 10 to the power of minus 3. 10 to the power of minus 3 coulombs. Okay. Now which parameter here? Electron. Like electron charge. Already know the electron charge. Then E is equal to 1.602 into 10 to the power of minus 19 coulombs. Now which parameter of how many electrons? Now the from the equation Q is equal to NE. Then Q is equal to NE. Now which parameter? N. N means the number of electrons. Now we find it from the equation. Then N is equal to Q by E. If not already given from N equal to the charge Q is equal to how much? 1 millicoulomb and 1 into 10 to the power of minus 3 coulombs upon an electron charge how much? 1.602 into 10 to the power of minus 19 coulombs. 1.602 into 10 to the power of minus 19 coulombs. But already the value is equal to 1 by 1.602 e 10 to the power of minus 19. So the value is equal to n equal to 6.25 into 10 to the power of 19. This value 10 to the power of minus 3. Finally, we get the number of electrons that n equal to 6.25 into 10 to the power of 18 minus 3. That is equal to 15. This is how many electrons you consider in 1 millicoulomb? How many electrons you consider? N equal to 6.25 into 10 to the power of 15 electrons. Okay. Now we do simple problems. 1 milli. Now here 1 micro. We do the problem, another problem. Okay. Similarly, nano and pico. Okay. This is all. But now we discuss about the next topic, like charges. Like charges. What is the meaning of light charges? Simple.
The charges, if the charges have same polarity, the charges are called like charges. For example, plus Q and plus Q, it has same charges, same polarity. Similarly, minus Q and minus Q, same polarity. These charges are called like charges. What are like charges? If the charges have same polarity, now we observe plus, minus, minus. These are called like charges. Okay? But here, plus, which force acts on between two charges here? Same charges, like charges. Now, important point out. Always, like charges are repelled to each other. That means that repulsive force acts on between like charges. Okay. Now, next is the word for dislike charges. Dislike charges. But what is the meaning of dislike charges? Simple. Here, like charges means same polarity, but dislike charges have different polarity. This is the plus Q, it is the minus Q, and minus Q, and plus Q. Now, we have observed from like charges and dislike charges. Here, same polarity, but here, different polarity. That means, if the charges have different polarity, the charges is called dislike charges. These are called dislike charges. Dislike charges. Now here, but which force acts on like charges, sir? That means only repulsion force acts on like charges. But here, because the charges are different, with plus and minus. Here, only attraction force acts on between like dislike charges. Okay? Now, this topic is the most important, is the most topic. What is the Coulomb's inverse square law? Coulomb's inverse square law in electricity. In electricity. What is the statement of the topic? Coulomb's inverse square law in electricity. It is the most important topic. What is the statement of this topic? The statement. What is the most important statement? First of all, statement. Okay, what is the statement? The attraction or repulsion force between two charges. Second, the attraction or repulsion force between two. Attraction force, which charges are like that? Dislike charges. Repulsion force, there is a like charges. Okay? The attraction or repulsion force between two charges. These are always directly proportional to the product of the charges and inversely proportional to the square distance between two charges. This is the statement of the Coulomb's inverse square law. Again, the attraction or repulsion force between two charges. The attraction or repulsion force between two charges is always directly proportional to the product of magnitude of two charges and inversely proportional to the square distance between two charges. The square distance between two charges. Okay? It is the statement of Coulomb's inverse square law in electricity. Once again, the attraction or repulsion force between two charges is always directly proportional to this important. Directly proportional to the product of magnitude of two charges and inversely proportional, it is important, and inversely proportional to the square distance between two charges. It is the statement of the Coulomb's inverse square law. Okay, for now, explanation of Coulomb.
Now, explanation. Further. Explanation for Coulomb's law. Now, let us consider two charges. Which are Q1 and Q2. These are two charges. Either like this or this like charges. Or separated for a distance of which are. The attraction force and the repulsion force between two charges is capital. Once again, now we consider two charges. What are they? Q1 and Q2. These are like charges, sir. This like charges. So separated distance is how much? Or the attraction or repulsion force between two charges is capital. Now, according to the statement of Coulomb's law, what is the statement? The attraction repulsion force between two charges is always directly proportional to the product of magnitude of charges. Now, the attraction or repulsion force, it is directly proportional to product of magnitude of two charges, Q1 and Q2, Q1 and Q2. From the statement, another. And the inversely proportional to the square distance. What is the distance, friends? Or, now we can write. It is inversely proportional to 1 by square. The equation 2. Outside of the statement. The repulsion or attraction force is directly proportional to the product of magnitude of two charges. And inversely proportional to the square distance between two charges. Okay. From 1 and 2. What happened then? Then P is directly, we can write that P is directly proportional to Q1, Q2 by R square. Finally, we get the equation when the proportions is removed, then P is equal to K into Q1, Q2 by R square. Now we have from this equation. K is proportional. So K is equal to 1/4πε₀. This value substitution in the place K, we get F is equal to 1/4πε₀ of Q1 Q2 by R square. This is the Coulomb's inverse law. But from this equation, what is F₁₀? F₁₀. It is a permittivity of free space. Permittivity of free space. The value of F₁₀, that is equal to 8.825 into 10 to the power of minus 12. Now we need to double show. Coulomb, sir. Meter squared by Coulomb square. Newton meter squared by Coulomb square. Now this value is equal to 1/4πε₀, that is equal to 9 into 10 to the power of 9. 9 into 10 to the power of 9. In reverse units, then Coulomb square by Newton into meter square. It is the Coulomb's inverse law in the next.